after it.
We made a hovercraft. I wasn't sure if we could. My kids know a whole lot about Minecraft, but we don't really know anything about hovercraft. We just got the idea to put a duct behind the prop on our carpet cruiser from a comment on that video and figured we'd give it a try. Thanks for the idea, Kevin. Kevin actually has a YouTube channel of his own full of cool ideas like that. I'll put a link in the description. The first time I tried to start it up, I had the motor wired backwards. I thought I killed the motor, but it turns out I killed the ESC. Not the first time I've done that, actually. Fortunately, we have a spare. Let's try that again. It worked, but it was slow. We figured it was too heavy, but before we started trimming weight, we tried just cutting one big hole under the duct on the base to let as much air as possible through. That actually made a big difference. Then I got to work reducing weight. I made the walls of the duct thinner and trimmed down the electronics basket. Finally, to really maximize our weight reduction, we printed the ducted motor mount in our old friend, the King of String, Air PLA! This stuff is really unpleasant to work with. Our 85A TPU is also stringy, but at least it melts easily. Air PLA just doesn't. Anyway, after all that weight reduction, it was still slow. So I kept experimenting. I tried a smaller piece of cardboard, but that didn't really help.
Ow.
I tried wrapping the battery and electronics in plastic to improve aerodynamics. That helped a little, but it still wasn't great. I tried having it ride on a freezer bag, but that bulged out to one side and tipped over. So I stapled it down. That worked a little better, but still not great. Then I tried folding the bag over, so it was only as wide as the cardboard. Now we're getting somewhere. The final design has the cardboard inside the bag.
13.5. It's right about there. Gotta flip these over and tape them on inside the bag.
Carefully slide the tape in. Oh, carefully place the tape.
And boom. One. Poke. Poke.
After some experimentation with hole placement, we got it working pretty well. We're still aiming to make this thing fly, but I guess hovering is one step closer. I'll put links to download the 3D printing files for this hovercraft in the description in case you want to give it a go. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next week.
That was a good one.
Yeah.